Hello and welcome to another episode of F1 2022 My Team Career. In this episode, we'll be checking out the Pirelli Hot Lap and the Belgian Grand Prix, or otherwise known as Spa. So let's jump right on in and catch all of the action. Attempt 2. Let's actually try to hit Eau Rouge properly this time. Might have been able to get around that in seconds, but not on this attempt. Okay, we got up Eau Rouge, a little bit twitchy with the car. And across the line. Oh, easy. 172.76 average, we needed 168. Very, very easy lap for us indeed on that one. Actually, P7 at the moment.
Okay, someone's just posted a faster time. That drops you down to the fourth row, P7.
So actually have P8. Stay on. Already so much better through there.
Belgium once again for today's round of the Formula One World Championship. It's a race that the great Ayrton Senna won 6 times, and in 2019, Charles Leclerc became the first driver to take their maiden win here since Michael Schumacher back in 1992. So here we are once again, ready to go racing through the Ardennes Forest. 4.35 miles of long straights, fast corners, and massive elevation changes. It makes this not only one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar, but one that makes for some consistently high-quality racing as well. Simply put it, there's no place quite like it. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole, edging out Max Verstappen. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Let's start with the new Alfa Romeo driver. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Okay. We're going to try this strategy. just need to stay out of chaos.
The formation lap gets underway then, and it's going to be interesting today to see how the dry conditions could affect the lifespan of the tires.
We're going to try for the medium strategy, medium to soft strategy, in the hopes of running along and pitting onto Anders. Our pit stop strategy isn't even on there. I don't know why mediums to hards is a strategy, but not mediums to softs. See, I need to try to overtake people into T1, but at the same time, I also need to play conservative. And not be in the start. That's actually a good start. How have we had such a horrible exit from that? Probably because I forgot to turn on ERS. John, I fucked it already. Just need to keep the AI close. That's all we gotta do. I don't need to do anything too fancy. Speaking of. See track limits. No shit. I don't really know how that's a corner cutting warning though. Very wide through there. Now we're already on our second warning.
We're expecting some rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes.
I don't need it to rain now, I need it to rain after the AI start pitting. We're also out of ERS now.
The underbody's taking a little damage, just watch out for it.
They're so much faster up the hill. Ah, scheiße. Oh, almost ran into the back of the Alpha and that actually fucked me again. Shit. Twice now I've fucked that corner in this race. People are pitting shit.
Oscar's coming in for his stop now.
That corner up well. Oh, I keep catching Joe and Latifi, and then I keep losing them right away. Completely missed that corner. Oh god. Shut up, I'm racing like shit.
Come on, you can win that place back.
No, I don't think I can. How much is the fucking issue?
Today, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition.
And George Russell wins.
Lane always has the potential to liven up a race and mix up the order, and they've taken full advantage of that to claim the victory today. It's always a bit of a lottery when the conditions are like this, but they've managed to stay on circuit and have come out on top.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it.
Well, that'll do it for this episode of F1 2022 My Career Mode. Unfortunately, another DF, or sorry, not DF, DNF. Actually, Oscar even DNF. I think he got. Did he get caught up in that crash that I had? So we will catch you next time, and hopefully, actually be able to finish race.